Beaches mean sand, right? But did you ever wonder what all that might look like under a microscope?
We were curious. Then we learned about Dr. Gary Greenberg. He invents powerful microscopes, which he uses to photograph different things like sand.
We wanted to know what made him curious, so we called him on Skype.
Aloha from Maui, Hawaii.
What makes sand different in different places?
It's amazing to me that every sample of sand that I've looked at looks different. Even on Maui alone, every beach looks different because it's a reflection of the erosion from the hills and the mountains, which brings all of the mineral-like elements down into the beach, and then it's also the biological life that lives on the ocean.
That biological life can leave things like teeth and bones, which break up into tiny grains of sand. But there are also teeny tiny animals called foraminifera, or forms for short. Each species makes itself a different house, tiny little shells called testes. Why is sand gold when you see it at the beach, but looks like a rainbow when you see it close up?
The little grains of sand are smaller than the resolution of what we can see. So if you were to look at a painting made of a whole bunch of dots, little tiny dots of all different colors, and you held that painting really a long ways away so you couldn't see any of the dots, it would look kind of beige colored because all the colors would come together and blend into one color. So that's what happens with sand.
Dr. Greenberg began inventing his microscopes 20 years ago to help him with his scientific research. We're sure glad he did because his photographs show us how every sandy beach has a beautiful world just waiting to be discovered. This photograph is of sand from our very own Sanibel Island. Amazing!